Hello, it's been a while since I've done a video. This one's a very simple fly. It's a bass fly, and I haven't used it for trout, but I've done very well with bass in various colors. It's not that difficult to tie. What I'm using is I'm going to use a big game hook, ST5500 number one. I'm using a 1/4 inch fluorescent orange bead. The problem with the size of the hook and the bead is that the hole is not quite big enough to go around. So I had to take a 3/32 metal drill, pair of pliers that has cushioned in it so I don't rub off the fluorescent orange, and drill the hole a little bit bigger, and it slides on real easily. Flat wax nylon thread, fluorescent orange. I'm going to make a nice little body with it, and I'm going to be using, this is a dubbing brush. I've made it out of Northern Flash and 1440 legs. Northern Flash is this one that has to be a perch color, and the flash is 3 to 3.5 inches long for the flash. And then I'm using three colors of legs in a 1440, an orange, a yellow, and an olive. And these I make are 4 inches to 4.5 inches long, pretty dense, as you can see on a dubbing brush. I've used this and I've tied about 6 flies, maybe a little bit more, and I can probably get a total of 10 out of here. We're not going to make very many wraps. You can on a longer hook, like a BH200, so you have a little bit denser, heavier looking fly, maybe like for a shad or something like this, but they're going to make this fairly thin. I'm going to tie it in right here, tie it down. Let me get my glasses on. Very simple. I'm going to make 2 wraps with this. That's it. I want this one fairly thin. The reason I want it thin, because I want it to go down a little bit more. So it'll be 2 wraps. I'm going to find a nice spot to tie it off. I'm going to make sure the legs are not tied down. Right. Think of an old pair of scissors, and I'm going to cut that in the wire, and I'm going to pull it back, pinch that wire down, and then tie it down. I'm going to go up here, and then I'm going to use is a super crack, and this is a special blend I made. I call it a perch. I'm going to do is make the fibers even on the ends. Not going to be very thick. I want it fairly thin. I'm going to fold it back and tie it about halfway up. Tie it down. Another batch. Do the same thing. Okay. Not too thick. Put it on the side. Tie it down, then I'm going to fold it back. I'm going to twist the bead a little bit and make sure it's not locked up yet. Okay. I'm going to whip finish it. Pull it tight. I'm going to take a UV glue and just go around this a little bit. Lock it in. You can see how that bead glows. You can use any color bead, but you make sure that hole is big enough to get on these bigger hooks. That is it. If the tail seems to have a little, like a long one, just cut it down. And that is, this is the perch one. I do have one here, which is one of my favorite colors, is a like a purple, black, and a lavender. Same thing, very slender. If you want to make them thicker, something like this. This is on a BH200 hook, and it has 6 wraps, so it's thicker, denser, and that works very well too. This has to be a smallmouth Northern Flash, and I'm using gold, brown, and I believe it's a black legs in here. And this is a vanilla copper type of northern kraken or kraken, super kraken dubbing with a black bead. There's various colors you can do on here. This is the perch, which I like very well, and my other favorite is this one right here. And then I've got a lot of smallmouth on something like this. That's like a crazy color. That's it. Extremely simple.
When my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on.